Captain Bear, and now you've got McDavid and Draisaitl back together. Over the line, 5-on-5. Draisaitl, a one-timer score from an impossible angle!
Was that what a shot? But he meant to do this. We've seen him score so many goals from a similar spot. He gets down to that corner. He is below the goal line when he rips this puck on net. For McDavid, no look. Bang, it's down to him. Look where he is standing. He is literally in the corner when he lets that go. And he beats Hogberg, and he just looks after him and says, are you kidding me? I mean, guys will try and do that in practice, put that in from that angle, and that is so difficult to do. What a shot by Leon Draisaitl.
Upshaw brought it back in. That long pass, score! Impossible angle.
Shots on Markstrom here. Scotty Upshaw just kind of flips this one into the corner, and for Brodziak, just takes it off that wall and throws it towards the net. That's a save you gotta have in this position of the game. We talked about it at the start of the game about giving up those sharp angle goals against. That's a goal you see coming, a shot that's on an angle, and just can't quite close the door on that strong side. 2-1 St. Louis.
Hit deep to the corner, twisting, turning, slides it around for Peugeot. And it gets away from him. Carlson's up there, trying to center it. Carlson scores!
What a great job by Mark Mathon. As this puck comes around, he out-battles Rick Nash, and that should keep the puck alive in the zone. And then it's Hoffman that picks it up, and the Senators get an opportunity to get some offensive zone play. Carlson sneaks down the boards here, and when he throws it, McDonough thinks it's already gone, but it's not. And then he's above the goal line. Players practice these things all the time, but this one goes off of something and heads back into the net. I don't know if it hit.
Yeah, hit Stepan.
Lundqvist, the back of his mask. It sort of glanced off the back of his mask and into the net.
Pesci again for Stepniak. This way it's Skinner off the boards. A tough angle. He scores! Jeff Skinner sneaks it by Calvin Picker. 48.5 seconds left in the first period. Carolina finds a way.
A variety of reasons. Skinner. Offensively, he needs to get back in top form for Carolina to have a chance to make the playoffs. It's been a period where Carolina has looked like a team that hasn't been on the ice for a variety of days. And he just throws a puck at the net. Now, this is the second sharp angle that Skinner has thrown a puck at the net.
Bozak got back to make a play. Now it's taken back by Jason Demers. Kurt Fiddler backhand to score!
At it, gets it back. Bozak gets on the right, wrong side of things for the Leafs defensively, and a mystifying super soft and super mo this one from the right wing side.
He can't score from there.
You can see the lefty eyes of Vern Fiddler elevates this thing. That is a perfect perfect backhand over the left shoulder, chips paint off the crossbar.
Along with Tom Kunackle, playing with the veteran Matt Cullen. Tom Wilson with the shoot-in as he got hit by Sundqvist. A sharp angle shot!
It's in.
It's in the net.
Absolutely.
The sharp
it's in
angle
and out.
In and out. And a Washington Capitals with a surprise attack and a shot along the goal line have a 1-0 lead.
An amazing play. Cross-corner dump that sits nicely, rolling a little bit, and up and over the shoulder of Murray. Just a stunned crowd here in Pittsburgh. And Glenn, I don't think you can make a better shot than that if you ever tried for Beagle. Just under the bar, right over the shoulder.
No, this one is predetermined and thought of before you even get to the puck.
Point shot in front, knocked away. A race for it, Nyquist. He's in the clear. Oh, he gets hooked. Right in. Couldn't bury it. Scores!
Oh, God.
He did it anyway. He still found a way. And it's 2-1.
Find the back of the net. There might have been a penalty shot being called here. I mean, very few hockey players in the NHL have the balance, the presence, the thought, the hands to do what he just did. Bishop.
Zuboff leading the charge to Lehtinen, and a bomb tipped away by Osgood into the far corner. Sidor watched, Langenbrunner picks it up. Now stick handling in the left circle, in front for Sidor. Here's Zuboff following up, a shot, he scores! got through Chris Osgood, and the Stars have tied the game.
Bettered him on that one. On the last one, Osgood never got himself square to the shot. He seemed to be cheating a little bit and pulled away from his post. And Sergei Zubov can paint the corner, and I think he did that on that one as it squeaked under the glove hand and the armpit of Osgood.
And something else opened up.
Well, that seam was wide open to get it over to Stoll on the left side each time. Here's Hansu. Hansu's behind the net. He dropped it off. Here's Frolov in the corner. Alexander Frolov feeds it down and deep. Shot by Moeller. He scores! He gets his first NHL goal. Oscar Moeller. And the Kings lead 1-0. Now this is part of the game with Oscar Moeller. He's never afraid or shy to shoot the puck. Maybe his biggest asset, his ability to shoot the puck. But this one here also falls into the game plan that Andre Kopitar was sending him out, and we were talking about earlier, Bob, and that's the goaltending problems the Avalanche have had. Now, it's a surprise play, but at the same time, it's a bad goal. Look at this. It comes from way down below the circles, but Moeller spotted something there. You could see the stick was up and a little bit of room between the pads, but Oscar Moeller will shoot the puck time and time again.
On Dubnyk, they're giving Marinchin the goal. And another one. Perron from a bad angle, and Roberto Luongo off to a tough start, 3-0 Edmonton, and the last two came from tough angles.
Does it hit Jason Garrison's stick? Just sneaks through. Roberto wasn't expecting Perron to shoot it from there. Jason Garrison reaches over, and it just sneaks by him. I don't think it hit Garrison's stick. I think it's just straight
in. Looks like.
Tapped off the center ice. Derek Brassard in the middle for Chris Letang. Swings it over to Crosby. On the backhand, protects it. Backhander, he scores! Sidney Crosby. Nobody does it better. Roofs a backhand, and the Penguins have a 1-0 lead.
Here he goes to the backhand. Smith goes down. Crosby goes up. Stairs. That backhand is back for Crosby.
The crowd are in it. Try to encourage the Jackets here as they trail by one. Nash from a shot. Yes. Bagel. He scores. The crowd encourages, and Nash comes through.
But watch Williams. He holds up here at the half boards and throws it to Nash. There's a little bit of movement in front. Now watch his floater. It's a knuckler. Goes over the right shoulder of UA. He has not been sharp at all here. That's why you want pucks thrown at him. And this one, exactly what the captain did.
The elementary school, thanks to the principal and thanks for all the kids.
Whoa! Tom Wilson scores from no angle, 8 seconds into the period.
Looked like the goaltender was sleeping on this play, saying, yeah, that's a goal mishandled. Look, it's sort of casual getting back into the net, Joe. And if you're going to be casual, that's going to happen. And Wilson slices it in. Look at the rolling puck. And it hits his left pad. And that's a dead end right off the draw. They win it. Hard rim. And watch the goalie come out. But he's casual getting back. And Wilson makes him pay.
Held in along the boards. Andrew Ladd checked by Coburn. Campbell holds the puck into the line. Turns. Won't shoot. Kane. Watched by Kimo Tiivanen. To the net. Stopped it. Where's the puck? It came loose on the other side. It's over. Patrick Kane has scored the goal. The Chicago Blackhawks' long drought is over.
And there it is.
There's the puck. What a remarkable end to a remarkable game, and what a season.
Let's watch as the puck goes through Leighton and right in the corner. Wow, got stuck underneath the netting. Leighton thought he had it. The only guy who saw it was that man, Patrick Kane.